Took a plane recently. I fly coach. Getting a little cramped there in coach. The rows are just so pressed together. I mean, it's ridiculous. You're sitting, there's no leg room anyway, but you're sitting there. The guy in the row in front of you leans back. His head becomes your whole trip. Oh, I'm eating now with your head. Maybe I'll have a drink and read a magazine with your head. They now have luggage stores at the airport. Who is home packing for getting this, huh? Let's see, I have my underwear and my socks and my toiletries. I'll just scoop this stuff up in my arms and get on the plane. Hope I don't drop my underwear off in the aisle while I'm looking for my seat. Dear Armor Meats, I want to take a 59-foot by 22-foot bologna on the plane with me. Will it fit in the overhead bin? I need this bologna to arrive in one piece, Southwest Funjet C Group boarding. I think a hot bologna in a hot plane in the hot sun is not such a good idea, huh? Hey, what time is it there in Nampa? It's 3 o'clock here. Sincerely, Ted L. Nancy, Meat Chair Committee.
Dear Mr. Nancy, I'm sorry to say, but we do not make bologna at this plant. I think you may have your measurements wrong. A bologna 59 feet by 22 feet would weigh 60,000 pounds. We wish you luck, Human Resource Manager.
Dear Colorado Bell Casino Lost and Found, I was visiting your casino recently as part of a semi-large to full mid-sized group. In my visit, I was distracted, confused, and lost from my group. My question, did you find a bag of otter hair? This hair is used as a second coat of hair for my 40-year-old otter, Lewis. The hair is grayish, brownish, yellowish, with reddish striping. It was in a pinkish, bluish, greenish bag. I hope that's not confusing. I am concerned my bag of otter hair will end up in the wrong hands, Tettle Nancy.
Mr. Nancy, I'm sorry we haven't been able to locate your bag of otter hair. Sincerely, Wilma, lost and found. It's probably in the dump.
Office of the Prime Minister of Greenland. Dear Prime Minister Kupik-Kleist, just a note to say that you are the best president of a foreign country I have ever seen. I admire you, and so do all members of our men's group that is made up of Greenlandians. There are 72 of us, 71 over age 50, and one who is 18 in November. We admire Greenland and what it means to be surrounded by all that ice. Without ice, what would we have? We would have no snow cones, no ice machines in hotels, no names for rappers. Nothing to chew on after we drink a beverage. Imagine a whole nation without ice. Freshen my drink. Can you please send us an autographed picture that we could put up over our refrigerator so every time we open the freezer door and get a blast of cold air, we are reminded of you? With utter respect, Ted L. Nancy.
Mr. Nancy, thank you for your letter and your interest in Greenlandic matters. I am glad to send you here a signed picture of Premier Kupik-Kleist. Yours sincerely, assistant to Mr. Kleist. Send this over now. Little kisses.